Throughout this website, you will find information about different football stadiums throughout the world, but especially those in Europe. But what about the stadiums that don't necessarily have clubs playing in them, for example, or are in parts of the world we may not necessarily cover? Some of those are massive, like really, really big, so shouldn't we talk about them too? Yes, yes we should. So we will. Right here, right now. This is your guide to the 10 largest stadiums in the world by capacity, starting with one in North Korea that Kim Jong-un says is the best ever. Ten. Azadi Stadium, Iran. The Azadi Stadium, which was formerly called the Erumer Stadium, is the home ground of the Iran national team. It is part of the Azadi Sport Complex and is in the middle of a rowing river, with football training pitches surrounding it alongside swimming facilities, a weightlifting complex, and more. It was renamed after the Iranian Revolution, changing from a moniker that meant Light of Aryans to the more appropriate Persian word for freedom. It was built in time for the 7th Asian Games in 1974 and was the focal point for Tehran's bid to host the 1984 Olympic Games. Though that bid was unsuccessful, the ground was used for the 1976 AFC Asian Cup and the 1999 and 2002 AFC Champions League Final. Unlike most other grounds, it has not hosted any particularly interesting music concerts, with the exception of Frank Sinatra, who performed there in 1975. In 2015, the Women's Islamic Games were also held there. 9. Borg El Arab Stadium, Egypt. Given that it is one of the top 10 largest stadiums in the world by capacity, surprisingly little is known about the Borg El Arab Stadium. We know it has a car park that is large enough to fit in 5,000 cars, for example, but we don't know what the highest attended match has been so far in the ground's history. We know there is an umbrella that covers 35% of the stadium, but we're unsure how much the stadium cost to build. The stadium was built as part of Egypt's bid to host the 2010 World Cup, with another 5 international standard grounds also planned for the same purpose. Along with the Cairo International Stadium and the Mubarak Stadium in Giza, it is one of the venues that hosts Egypt's international football matches. Though the capacity of the stadium is 80,000, 35% of the ground's total seating capacity is taken up by the terrace and first-class stand. The stadium was chosen to host matches in the 2009 FIFA Under-20 World Cup, although in the end it was only actually used for the opening game between Egypt and Trinidad and Tobago. A number of the FIFA delegation felt that the ground was virtually identical to the Stade de France, but FIFA's then-president Sepp Blatter, who has long been trying to extol the virtues of football in Africa, described it as fantastic, so we don't know who to believe. 8. Bukit Jalil National Stadium, Malaysia. The Bukit Jalil National Stadium was built with the specific aim of hosting the 1998 Commonwealth Games, which took place in Kuala Lumpur in September of that year. Since then, it has been the home of the Malaysia national football team. Considered to be the best ground in Malaysia, it is often used to host major tournaments that are held in Malaysia, such as the Southeast Asian Games, the ASEAN University Games, and the FESPIC Games. Like most major stadiums, it has also hosted music concerts for artists like Kelly Clarkson, The Corrs, Usher, and Linkin Park. As well as music concerts, the stadium has hosted track and field athletic events, the Malaysian FA Cup Final, the FA Premier League Asia Cup, the Champions Youth Cup Final, and pre-season tours for teams such as Manchester United, Chelsea, and Liverpool. It was renovated in 1998, and the capacity was expanded in the same year. 7. Gelora Bung Karno Stadium, Indonesia. The stadium is actually located inside a huge sporting complex in Jakarta, Indonesia. Though it's colloquially known as the GBK Stadium, its official name is Gelora Bung Karno Main Stadium, given because there are other stadiums located within the rest of the complex. The ground was built in time to host the 4th Asia Games in 1962, and the funding for the stadium came in part through a loan from what was then the Soviet Union. It had an original capacity of 120,800, but this was reduced to 88,083 when it was renovated in time for the Asia Cup in 2007. As well as being the home of the Indonesia national team, it is also the home ground of Persija Jakarta, which is a member of the top flight of Indonesian football. The ground has been used for a huge amount of football since it opened in the 1960s. From pre-season tours of famous clubs such as Liverpool, Arsenal, Juventus, and La Galaxy through to numerous Asia Games matches and Suzuki Cup games. It has also played host to a grand Catholic mass led by Pope John Paul II in 1989, the anniversary of the Indonesian National Awakening Day, and music concerts from bands like Deep Purple, Metallica, and Bon Jovi. 6. Wembley Stadium, England. The new Wembley Stadium opened in 2007, with its official opening coming in time for the 2007 FA Cup final between Chelsea and Manchester United, that the London club, Chelsea, won 1-0. It is the home of the England national football team and, as such, has hosted any number of international games over the years since it reopened. Its use is not limited to England matches, however. Every year it hosts the FA Cup semi-finals and final as well as the League Cup final and the FA Community Shield match. In 2011 and 2013 it was the venue for the Champions League final, and in 2012 it hosted the gold medal match at the Summer Olympics. It has hosted the Rugby League Challenge Cup final and NFL matches as well as numerous concerts. 5. Rose Bowl Stadium, United States. Primarily known as an American football stadium, the Rose Bowl is arguably the most important soccer grounds in the United States. It hosted the final of the FIFA World Cup in 1994, the final of the FIFA Women's World Cup in 1999, the 1984 Olympic gold medal match, and numerous CONCACAF and U.S. Soccer Federation matches. The ground opened in 1922 and is recognized as a national historic landmark in the U.S. It hosts the Rose Bowl American football game every year, and that's where it gets its name from. In fact, the ground was initially known as either the Tournament of Roses Stadium or Tournament of Roses Bowl until it was called the Rose Bowl just before the 1923 game of the tournament. 4. FNB Stadium, South Africa. The first National Bank Stadium, better known as FNB Stadium, but also called Soccer City or the Calabash, is the stadium that is used to host the home games of South Africa's football matches and the country's rugby games. It is also the home ground of the South African football team Kaizer Chiefs FC. It hosted the African Cup of Nations in 1996 and 2013, and also some of the games, including the final, when South Africa hosted the FIFA World Cup in 2010. 3. Estadio Azteca, Mexico. Located in the suburb of Santa Ursula in Mexico City, the Estadio Azteca is the home of the Mexican national team. It is also the home ground of Club America, who plays in the top flight of Mexican football. Over the years it has been used by other clubs such as Necaxa, Atlante, Universidad Nacional, Atletico Espanol and Cruz Azul. It is one of the most iconic stadiums in world football and was the first to host two separate FIFA World Cup finals. In 1970 Brazil defeated Italy 4-1 in the stadium, whilst in 1986 Argentina ruled the roost over West Germany with a 3-2 win there. English fans will know the ground well as it was the location for Maradona's famous Hand of God goal in the 1986 quarter-final between England and Argentina. 2. Camp Nou, Spain. Camp Nou has been the home of FC Barcelona since the 24th of September 1957. Since then it has also hosted the home matches of the Catalonia national team, and in 1992 it was one of the stadiums used when Spain hosted the Summer Olympics. The ground has hosted two Champions League finals and one of the semi-final matches at the 1982 FIFA World Cup. Until 1980 the capacity was just over 93,000, but it increased to 121,749 at the start of the 1980s. In 1993 this was reduced to 115,000, then in 2005, it was reduced once more to 98,772. In 2016 it increased slightly to its current capacity of 99,354, but there are plans underway to increase it even further to 105,000 by 2021. This will include a major redevelopment of the entire stadium. 1. Ringrado 1st of May Stadium, North Korea. In the 1990s it was claimed that the former Supreme Leader of North Korea, Kim Jong-il, picked up a golf club for the very first time at the opening of the Pyongyang Golf Complex. It contains North Korea's only 18-hole golf course that has a par of 72. The Supreme Leader went on to shoot an incredible 38 under par round of 34, of which 11 shots were holes in one. Now far be it for us to suggest that the North Koreans make things up, but that does seem a slightly unlikely result for someone who has never played golf before to manage. As such, it's entirely possible that the Ringrado 1st of May Stadium actually only has seating for about 150 people, and the rest is made to appear larger thanks to the intelligent use of mirrors. That's probably not true, of course, and the claim of a 150,000 capacity is a totally genuine one. Like, share, subscribe.